Welcome to the MIRTEC booth here at SMT Connect. I'm delighted to be joined by Rui Gesero. Nice to see you again, Rui.
Nice to see you too, Trevor.
Yeah. So, always new things here at the MIRTEC booth. One of the things I want to look at, there's always a big problem with training and being able to get people, actually, operators, to work in these factories. So, companies need to have systems that where they can essentially train people quickly, or even reinforce that training if they're coming, or you know, maybe they did the job before and then they're coming back to the job to that level. You've got a system here for helping to walk people through the different parts of inspection. Can you talk to us about that?
Yeah, thank you very much. So one thing we noticed from our customers is that it happens quite a lot for companies that don't have to create a program every day or that have multiple people working on the machine, that there are some people that are better trained than others.
Yeah.
Which leads to that some people simply forget small steps that are crucial to creating a new inspection program. It's not only that it might lead to a worse outcome on inspection, but it could even mean that it just doesn't work at all because you forgot to click something that was crucial during that time. So we thought about how could we help our customers achieve a constant quality even if the personnel fluctuate.
Yeah.
So if they get new people or if people change where they work to. So we came up with what we call the model creation wizard. We try to do something that is familiar to people, so everyone knows the installation wizard at Windows,
mm-hmm.
that goes step by step and explains what am I doing, what do I need to do next. And it's like five, six simple steps that go, you have to name your product, you have to set the width of your transport system, you have to put certain setting in, you have to analyze the board and let the AI choose the components for you,
yeah.
and so on. And so what it does is basically take a little bit first out of the fear that the new worker might have about the complex machine. It makes it easier, more friendly, and it gives the companies that invest in such a solution the security that they know, even if they have to change personnel, a few steps can be taught very quickly,
very quickly.
Simply,
yeah.
and you can standardize them, meaning you don't have to fear that on Monday morning the shift and on Friday evening the shift will result in different quality and different inspections.
Yeah.
So I think this is one thing I'm very proud of that
yeah.
we are introducing here at the SMT show for the first time to the
mm-hmm.
public,
mm-hmm.
and I'm looking forward to have the customer feedback during the show.
Yeah, well, it certainly makes a lot of sense to me, for sure, you know, to have a system there, either to train them from scratch or for reinforcement later on. Now you've got another system on here which is another new development that compares your SPI data with your AOI data. Can you talk to us a bit about that?
Yes, so this is one of the second most asked for thing that customers approached us, like how do I make is easier for my people is, hey, I don't want to walk from my AOI to my SPI all the time just to check the database why a certain error appears. So here on the AOI we're standing for in the mm-hmm. MV6 Omni, we can see the MV6 Omni has found a problem at the solder joint, so it's an insufficient solder. And at the same time, we get at the bottom the results from the SPI to see if it actually came from the printing process. So in this case, we have insufficient solder, but the pad data looks okay.
Yes.
So you now know the issue is not at my printer. I can go to the next step and maybe check my pick and place machine or my oven if there is an issue with that.
Right.
Without this information, either not having an SPI at all, you would have guessed. So most
right.
common error is the printing problem. But now, since you have a MIRTEC SPI and a MIRTEC AOI, you can just get the data here, can make a quick decision, and then plan your next step.
Yeah, you can see clearly there's sufficient volume there, but
exactly.
on the AOI, it looks like it's just missing the end. It's,
exactly. Yeah. And at the same time, you get the criteria, so the machine will tell you
mm-hmm.
why it's saying it's not sufficient, and the SPI will tell you why it says it's okay.
Yes.
So you can compare the hard data, and for our friends from the EMS, who are provider,
mm-hmm.
they can showcase the customer, because maybe this you notice now we know this is an error, but maybe this would be a false call. And right. now you suddenly notice, hey, I programmed this right, but I have to optimize my program here. And now you have in the documentation, when you override the decision, you have the documentation to show, hey, dear customer, it was everything okay. I just messed up programming first time. Now it's good.
Okay. Okay, that's great. So, and the third thing I want to talk about today is actually the programming, because you've optimized that in a way where you're not having to, the system's not having to take into account areas that are not needing to be inspected. I mean, every board has breakout areas or areas where there's not a density of components, so it doesn't, you don't need to inspect everywhere.
Yes, exactly. So we were proud to show at the Apex our first top speed mode. Mm. So we have our speed level one, where we enhance the inspection speed with the with on software level. So, and as you explained very well right now, the next step was to there. You might have a board that has a very big field of view thanks to the MIRTEC machine, and you can see a lot of stuff, but maybe not everything is an area of interest. Something is just an empty area that is not populated. Mm-hmm. So the machine can now suggest an optimization of this inspection area to make the field of view, for example, a little bit smaller, so we will save data, can transmit faster, and you will also save data on your hard drive, meaning right. you don't have to document as much, you don't fill up your space as much, because this can also be an issue. Absolutely. And this is what we are introducing also on the SMT show, mm-hmm. to show that you don't have to be a programmer, you don't have to have deep knowledge of the system, mm-hmm. it will just auto-suggest to you how to make this smaller and to save time and save space.
Okay, but then just to tease everybody, you know, you're telling me you've made a 25% improvement, but you're just in first gear.
Exactly. So now, as I briefly mentioned, this is just software level improvement. So we made a few tweaks, we made our machine run a little better, but in the background we are working on some interesting stuff, and I think people will be very happy to see at the Productronica maybe this year, mm-hmm. to have a show how MIRTEC quality can be done in real high speed mode.
Right, right. Well, we'll certainly look out for that, Rui. It's going to be an interesting show for sure. But lots of new things that you've shown us today, and it's quite exciting. So congratulations and thanks very much.
Thank you very much, Trevor. It was nice having you here.